Congressman Barney Frank has been at the center of banking and economic policy for many years. He represents the 4th District of Massachusetts, and he's a 16-term congressman who launched his committee on the most sweeping overhaul of banking and financial regulations since the Great Depression, an overhaul not welcome with glee by GOP counterparts and candidates. That's an understatement. Congressman, thanks so much for being here.
Cool.
So the financial situation is obviously still crummy. Is there a sense that you pick up among your voters that the banking situation is still working against them?
30 years ago, when people borrowed money, like the target audience here that right. we're talking to, they borrowed money from the person they were going to pay back. And every month they paid that person back. And if you're going to pay me back, I'm going to be careful about lending you the money. Then came securitization, whereby people lent money to a lot of people and then sold the right to be paid back. And surprise, surprise, when people don't expect to be paid back, they lend more money than they otherwise would have. We've put in there a strict requirement that 5% of the loan has to be held by the person who lent it, and it's the top 5% in terms of losses. That's one about which there's a very vicious battle going on, but I believe we're going to hold firm, and that's the kind of thing that will stop bad things from happening.
With the boomers and seniors in particular, are you saying that they're really in a bind in terms of banks and no interest?
Right. Well, there is this conflict because to stimulate the economy, the Federal Reserve is appropriately trying to hold down interest rates, but that does cause a problem for someone who has saved. The interest rates are down. The problem is if they go back up again, then that chokes off other kinds of activity. That's why I wish that we had a Congress that was ready to do stimulation through the government spending, and then the Federal Reserve wouldn't have to do as much. If we would do some of the things that would get jobs back in the economy, then there would be less pressure on the Federal Reserve. In fairness to them, since the Republicans have shut down any effort to do job creation through the spending, they've had to do too much of that through the monetary policy.
As you know, some of these protests that are sweeping the country started about greed on Wall Street. Let me give you an example, though. Let's say someone brings me a bundle of mortgages. Says, I've selected these mortgages, I think they're going to go bad, but see if you can sell them. I sell them to you. And I don't disclose that the guy who brought them to me says he thinks they're going to go bad. You buy them. Now, I take a position against them, even though I've sold them to you. Shouldn't I go to jail?
Well, I don't know what the criminal was. They were certainly wrong. Those are things
that
were done by both Goldman and by
Citicorp.
Here's the problem. One of the reasons more people haven't gone to jail is that not enough things were illegal. More people would go to jail if they did that going forward. Part of the problem was that you did have this lack of regulation. So there were things that were wrong, but they weren't necessarily illegal. We have done things that will stop that kind of thing from happening. In particular, it was, people made mortgage loans that never should have been made. Then they packaged them and sold them. We have done a number of things that will make that impossible in the future.
You talk about a lack of regulation, but of course we keep hearing from your Republican colleagues that the way to stimulate job growth and all of that is to get rid of regulations, that they're strangling business. I mean, is that a fair statement?
Apparently in the parallel universe in which some of them live, that's true. We had the worst recession since the Great Depression, according to, and by the way, it started under the Bush administration. And I am quoting now Bush's top economic appointees, Ben Bernanke, Henry Paulson, Secretary of the Treasury. And they said things are shutting down because there was too little regulation. What we have done in the financial area doesn't stop any legitimate activity. Let me give you a distinction. We talk about derivatives. If you're an airline, you have a good reason to hedge on the price of fuel because you don't want your price of fuel going so wildly that you can't make rational calculations. So where you're the user of a commodity to produce a good or a service, you're not as tightly regulated. But if you are AIG selling it to Morgan Stanley and vice versa, the kind of thing that causes problems, then we tightly regulate you. In other words, we make a distinction between purely financial transactions between financial institutions and people doing real work. And I'm glad that we've shut down some of those, the financial razzle-dazzle. That was not business that was contributing anything to the real economy.
Congressman Barney Frank, thanks very much for joining us today.